Hey lovies, welcome to my channel, Craft Away with May. I'm May. I'm so excited today, you guys. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I'm doing my very first YouTube collaboration video with the lovely Miss Jenny over at Lovely Moments Creating. If you are new here, you're probably coming over from her channel. So thank you. Thank you so much for coming by to see what I have going on today. If you're returning, thank you for coming back to hang out with me. Full disclosure, you guys, before we get started, especially to the new people, I live close to a main highway, and unfortunately, I have limited space and time of when I can record, and you will hear some noise in the background. I'm usually pretty good about canceling it out throughout the actual video, so this may be the only time that you'll hear the majority of it, but I just wanted to put that out there, and I hope it doesn't discourage you from watching the entire video. So, today's theme is summer theme. Majority of my crafts are geared towards outdoor living spaces, so you will see more of tabletop decor, lighting, and things of that nature. So, most of the items did come from the Dollartree, as well as other budget-friendly stores, and the ones that did not come from the budget-friendly stores were still purchased on a budget. Hello. All right. So hopefully you can draw some inspiration from them, you know, maybe duplicate them, recreate them, you know, put your own little spin on it, whatever the case may be. Now, I think I said this, but if I didn't, I will have Jenny's channel linked in the description box below. So once you're done here, if you haven't already done so, go check her out. Her work is awesome. It's phenomenal. And I'm not just saying that, like she was one of the very first YouTubers that I, found on here, and I have watched her ever since that day, and her work is just impeccable, you guys. You will love it. It's so clean, so sleek, it's just nice. And I'm not even just saying that, it's really nice. It's like beautiful. I tell her all the time. So yes, so I hope you guys enjoy the content, and again, I hope you guys stick around. I hope you consider subscribing, liking, and hitting that bell notification just so I upload a video. Now, also, we'll give you guys another disclosure. I am very new to YouTube. I've only been on about 4 or 5 months, so I don't have a whole lot of content, but that is my goal as we go into the future to get more content out there. But I hope you guys go back and check out the things I have and let me know what you think. If you have a channel that you are here on YouTube and you'd like me to check it out, leave that name in the comments below and I'd be more than happy to go check out and see what you have going on your channel. So I won't hold you guys up so you don't have to hear all that rustle and bustle in the background, and let's just go ahead and jump into the video. Later. All right, lovey, so we're going to start with this very first project, and all of my projects today are kind of coastal beachy theme, if you will. So I hope you really enjoy it, but we're going to start here with this mason jar. And as you know, normally around spring and summertime, we do a lot of decor pieces with lemons, honeys, when we're doing the mason jar. And I decided to, you know, kind of switch it up a little bit. I didn't know really how it was going to go, but I decided to, you know, play a rebel and just go with it. So what I decided to do was a sweet tea mason jar. So I'm super excited about this. I am going to be using colors from Folk Art and Hello Hobby, I believe, which is the brand at Walmart. So I am going in. Clearly you can see the lid is going to be black. Here I'm just making an outline of where I want the fill line for, you know, to give that illusion that the jar has tea in it. So I go in with the aqua color by Hello Hobby, and then I'm going to go in with the wild mushroom color. Now I did get a little concerned because the aqua was a little bit darker than what I anticipated, but as well as the mushroom looks more like cocoa. But actually, once you know it dried and I added the lettering to it, it was totally, it just came together very nicely, and you'll see that here. So what I'm doing here is I'm going in with a smaller paintbrush because you could see those pencil lines through, which is what I wanted because I needed that as my guide once I went in with the paint, but my hand just wasn't steady enough, so I did have to bring in that wood round just to get it steady because it was just not the same as using a pencil, of course. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm really just trying to define that outline because I want to give that illusion and I wanted to make it as realistic as possible. And while I was doing this, I was like, this really, it looks awesome. It looks like watercolor paintings to me. A little bit darker than watercolor, but that's the vibe I got from it. But so what I decided to do here was going with some distressing, just because I felt like with pieces like this, you have to do that because it creates that illusion of what you're trying to go after here. And I really wanted to blend everything together. I did not want it so disjointed, you know. So I am going in with some parchment color paint by Folk Art and just trying to blend it all together and just stay down the midsection there. It did give off a little bit, not the parchment color, but the just the whole paint in general, the whole project, the whole piece. It had some very distinctive vertical lines there, and I was trying to blend those. I'm not sure how that happened. But nonetheless, I went in and I printed out Sweet Tea for my Cricut Joy. I'm going to be using some nautical rope here, as well as some beautiful straws that I found at my Dollartree on this project, and also some 3D shells, which I'm going to be using on that crate. And yes, I did show that out of order. So all I did was here tape off that nautical rope and cut it down to keep it even and applied a little bit of glue. Now right here, I kept this in here because this freaks me out, because it's like the second time that this happened to me where I go to pick up something and it literally just, it pops away from my hand, and I'm not sure what that's all about. So it really did freak me out, but I just went in with another one. I cut it down and stuck it in there because I was like, okay, we're not supposed to use straws in our mason jars. Like, yeah, we are. We're supposed to, right? We have to keep it classy. So no, but nonetheless, I love the way that came out. And you'll see at the end, once I put everything together, how beautiful it all came together. I'm going to stay with the same color scheme on pretty much all the projects for the, all the pieces for this first project. And I got these little crates here. These are the mini crates from Dollartree. I absolutely love these things. Like, they are so versatile. You can do so many things with them, even though they're small. Like, they are just really, really nice to have around. So whenever I can find them, I usually grab, two or four, because I love to buy in twos. But yeah, and so I just really go in with the same color, as I was saying, going with the same color scheme as I did with the mason jar, minus the black. I did not include the black here, which is literally for the lid of the mason jar. And while I have you guys' attention, you know, I'm super excited about being in this collaboration with Miss Jenny today. And if you have not already checked her out, if by some strange chance you found my channel first, please click the link below in my description box and go check her out. Like, she is so awesome. She's a sweetheart of a lady, super talented. I mean, her work is just so just awesome and clean and sleek. I love it. I can't say it enough. I tell her all the time. It's grade A, you know. So definitely go ahead and check her out. I'm so grateful for her today of collaborating with me. I truly, truly am. And so what you see that I'm doing here is I decided to take some of that nautical rope and add it to the side of the larger wood crate there, which I did get that from Daiso. It was like $1.25 at the time, I believe. And nonetheless, it, you know, it's a larger version of what we saw there from the ones from Dollartree. And so I'm just going in with the 3D stickers, and I had to disassemble them or reassemble them because you can see the foam tape in between, because I am going to use one of the Dollartree lights or their hanging lights there. And I was super excited to find those. That was a great find because I have not seen those at any of my other Dollartrees. So here I am going in with the little shadow boxes from Michael, as well as this long wood sign from Michael. And I'm going to paint all that white. And so right here, what I'm doing is I'm taking a placemat that I got from Daiso. It is a paper placemat. I thought it reminded me of like under the ocean, like, or in the sea, you know. And all I did here was I sprayed a little bit of water on it, and then I clamped it together for a couple of days, and it held that shape. And I was so excited because I really didn't think it would hold. I thought maybe I needed like to add like some Mod Podge or something to it, or hairspray to hold it, but it stayed, and I was happy. Those lights I got from Dee Dee's, which is a sister store to Ross, and they are vanity lights. If you couldn't tell, I'm sure you could, but they were super bright, which I loved. I really love that about them, especially up against the white. But I did want to tone it down just a little bit, so I'm just taking some pansies that I got. Either I got these from Walmart or I got these from Dollartree. I'm not 100% sure. But nonetheless, I just went in randomly and just stuck them all over. And because that long sign has a border around it, I was able to just slide them in and hide the stems so they're not poking out on the side. And that's literally all I did with this, you guys. I did go in, I did put string through a piece of jute twine just because, you know, it wasn't stiff, so I didn't want it to, you know, flop over. And I just tied that in, I strung it through. I thought maybe it would stand out a little bit, but even with me knowing where it was, I had a little bit of a challenge locating it, which was really good. And that's all I did. I didn't glue anything down here. I could have, because the switch to turn the lights on is on the side. However, you know, I just opted not to. I really like the fact that I can really change these things around. You know, that's just less legwork down the line. And that's literally all I did with that. And you guys will see how beautiful it is when I turn down the lights. It looks like something under the ocean. Next, I went in with these. I don't know if they're called, is it terrariums or something like that? I think that's the word. If not, you guys know what I'm trying to say. But I found these at Daiso, and it has this little slim glass bottle there. I know it's not showing up that great on the screen right here, but I love this. It's very sleek. And I just took one stem of the pansies and put it in each one, and that's literally all I did with those. I was gonna paint them white, but I opted not to because I like the contrast of that against that white and purple. And you guys will see, I promise you, you will love it. And here I'm just using a serving tray. I'm repurposing it. I got this from Hobby Lobby on clearance. I got a couple of these, a few actually of these. They're like $2.24, so I grabbed as many as I could. But all I'm doing here is I went in with that white, and by the way, that's the Adirondack white by Folk Art that I used on all the pieces today. And all I'm doing is taking my Cricut tool, weeding tool. I would not recommend doing this. This is just what I had by me. I was too lazy to get up and get something else, but I'm just going in to define those lines because it kind of reminded me of shiplap a little bit. And so I just wanted to define them, not make even straight across lines, but you get what I'm talking about. And here for the shadow boxes, I thought I was going to use quite a bit of butterflies today, but at the end of the day, I opted not to. So I took the little shadow boxes from Michael's, and I went in with these roses. Now, I know roses, they're not, you know, beachy or nautical or coastal, but I love the colors here. And I just was like, I'm going to tie these in here anyway, because I wanted to do what these are going to go on that tray, and I wanted the tray to be kind of a play on a tier tray. Of course, it's not going to be tiered, it's just a single tray, but I just wanted to add something to it, and you guys will see. It just looks so, I don't know, nautical. It's so cute. And I went in with these butterflies that I got from Michael's, the roses came from Hobby Lobby, and here it all is, guys, all together. I thought I had got a larger shot of this, but I think I may have switched my camera around. So maybe if you turn your camera sideways, you might get a full scale. But the jars here with the jute twine, I got those from Dollartree. I went in, I took a few sprigs of leaves off of one of my faux plants I have, and I put it in there with some of the seahorse fairy lights you see there. I put in some pearls, some river rocks, some beads, just like, you know, just kind of like a treasure chest type of vibe on there. And then I took the rest of that nautical rope, added it here. I had a long string of beads that I had from a costume party. And also that three-tier planner I got from Michael's during the screen sale. And those shells I got from Walmart, which I've had forever. Yes, my little beach sign. I left it crooked like that because I thought that was super cute. Like, I just wanted it to not be perfect. But here it is all together, you guys. And I just really, really love the way this came out. And so this one, y'all, this is my favorite. I think this is my favorite. Let me know what you guys think, if you had a favorite. And what I did here was I took one of the little ladders from Dollar Tree where it has the love, it's spelled love on there, and I just took out the letters from that and I painted in the same color scheme of what I have here, and then I put the towel over it, which I got from Dollar Tree as well. I just wanted to give it like that beach towel hanging over, if that makes sense. And then I have a little sun hat, which I think I got from Hobby Lobby, but I could have very well gotten it from Michael's, not 100% sure again. But this here, you guys, I love everything. I love that sweet tea sign, y'all. Oh my gosh, it looks so gorgeous. But I love everything about this particular craft today. And I would just love to hear your guys' feedback if you enjoyed it. And also, before I close out, or before we go to the next pieces, if you haven't done so already, please click that link below and go check out Jenny's channel at Lovely Moments Creating. She is awesome, you guys. She is so awesome. You will not be disappointed. She's just a true talent here on YouTube. So do me that favor and go check her out if you haven't done so already. And this one, you guys, this was like the most simple project today, but I feel like it just came out absolutely gorgeous. It just had that whole under the sea vibe, Hawaii under the sea vibe, you know, and it just, it surpassed my expectations. It's simple and gorgeous. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And so this one here is something I threw in. It was a project that I worked on for a friend of mine. She did an order for her kitchen. She wanted some pieces. She's really into the farmhouse thing. And I didn't get to share video on this because I didn't get the opportunity to record. But I did want to share the outcome. And I'm super proud of this. Like, this was my first full kitchen decor piece for someone else. So I absolutely love the way it all came together. She loved it, which was, you know, made me happy. But yeah, you know, let me know what you guys think. If you guys have a favorite today, or if there's something you're interested in seeing. I even drew out the little pig and cow. Like, it didn't come that way. I freehanded that. I was super impressed with myself there. But hopefully you guys will like the content that I'm sharing here on my page. And if you haven't already done so, please consider subscribing, hitting the like button, as well as the notification bell, just so you know every time I upload a video. Jenny girl, thank you so much for collaborating with me today. I so appreciate you. Touch my heart so very much. And lovies, as I always like to wrap up with, fall in love every day. Every day you have an opportunity to open your eyes. It's an opportunity to fall in love with at least one something that day. And also, I won't hold you guys up any longer. I'm just going to let you know, lovies, stay safe, stay kind, and happy crafting the days away. And I hope to see you all in the next video. Bye.